Good morning. My name is Renee Ruccolo. Welcome to Assumption Parish. Today is the 19th Sunday in Ordinary Time. Father Stephen Huber will preside at this morning's liturgy. Please stand.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. My sisters and brothers, in today's gospel, we hear the account of Jesus and Peter walking on the water. Peter struggled at times to walk on the water because his faith was weak. He didn't have his complete trust that God would save him and protect him. Many times in our own lives, we too struggle to trust in God. So as we prepare to celebrate this Eucharist, let us call to mind those times that we have not fully trusted in God, as we ask pardon for all of our sins, remembering that God is a God of mercy and love. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy. You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy. You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. And together we say, glory to God in the highest, and on earth, peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, O God, almighty Father. Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son. Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father. You take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world. Receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. Almighty, ever-living God, whom taught by the Holy Spirit we dare to call our Father, bring, we pray, to perfection in our hearts the spirit of adoption as your sons and daughters, that we may merit to enter into the inheritance which you have promised. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the first book of Kings. When Elijah reached Horeb, the mountain of God, he came to a cave and spent the night there. Then the word of the Lord came to him, saying, go out and stand on the mountain before the Lord, for the Lord is about to pass by. Now there was a great wind, so strong that it was splitting mountains and breaking rocks in pieces before the Lord. But the Lord was not in the wind, and after the wind, an earthquake. But the Lord was not in the earthquake, and after the earthquake, a fire. But the Lord was not in the fire. And after the fire, a sound of sheer silence. When Elijah heard it, he wrapped his face in his mantle and went out and stood at the entrance of the cave. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The responsorial psalm. Show us your steadfast love, O Lord, and grant us your salvation.
Show us your steadfast love, O Lord, and grant us your salvation.
Let me hear what God the Lord will speak, for he will speak peace to his people. Surely his salvation is at hand for those who fear him, that his glory may dwell in our land. Show us your steadfast love, O Lord, and grant us your salvation. Steadfast love and faithfulness will meet. Righteousness and peace will kiss each other. Faithfulness will spring up from the ground, and righteousness will look down from the sky. Show us your steadfast love, O Lord, and grant us your salvation. The Lord will give what is good, and our land will yield its increase. Righteousness will go before him and will make a path for his steps. Show us your steadfast love, O Lord, and grant us your salvation. A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, I am speaking the truth in Christ. I am not lying. My conscience confirms it by the Holy Spirit. I have great sorrow and unceasing anguish in my heart, for I could wish that I myself were accursed and cut off from Christ for the sake of my own people, my kindred, according to the flesh. They are children of Israel, and to them belong the adoption, the glory, the covenants, the giving of the law, the worship, and the promises. To them belong the patriarchs, and from them, according to the flesh, comes the Christ, who is over all. God be blessed forever. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Immediately after feeding the crowd with the 5 loaves and the 2 fish, Jesus made the disciples get into the boat and go ahead to the other side while he dismissed the crowds. And after he had dismissed the crowds, he went up to the mountain by himself to pray. When evening came, he was there alone, but by this time the boat, battered by the waves, was far from the land, for the wind was against them. And early in the morning, Jesus came walking toward them on the sea. But when the disciples saw him walking on the sea, they were terrified, saying, "It is a ghost." And they cried out in fear. But immediately Jesus spoke to them and said, "Take heart, it is I. Do not be afraid." Peter answered him, "Lord, if it is you, command me to come to you on the water." Jesus said, "Come." So Peter got out of the boat, started walking on the water, and came toward Jesus. But when he noticed the strong wind, he became frightened, and beginning to sink, he cried out, "Lord, save me." Jesus immediately reached out his hand and caught him, saying to him, "You of little faith, why did you doubt?" When they got into the boat, the wind ceased, and those in the boat worshiped him, saying, "Truly, you are the Son of God." The Gospel of the Lord. Throughout a lot of my time in formation for the priesthood, there were many different people, whether it was my novice director or seminary professors, other bazillions that I lived with, that would speak about the first reading that we heard today from 1 Kings and use it to show the importance of taking time for prayer, the importance of looking for that silent place where we can hear the voice of God speak. And it is true, it is important that we need to spend that time in prayer. But I think that this passage can sometimes give us a little bit of a false impression or false interpretation of what that time in prayer might look like. Because it might lead us to believe that all of these things that cause noise, that might keep us from hearing the voice of God, are going to happen in succession. There's going to be fire, there's going to be wind, there's going to be earthquake, and then there's going to come a point when all of that stops and we'll be able to clearly hear the voice of God. And I don't know about those of you that are here or those of you joining us online for this Mass, but I think I could probably count on one hand the number of times where I've had that absolute silence that I've been able to clearly hear the voice of God. I think far more often our prayer time might be more akin to what Peter experiences in the gospel reading that we hear today. Because there's times that we can try to put aside all of the outside distractions. We can turn off the TV, we can turn off the computer, we can turn off the cell phone, and we still find that there is noise coming from within our own head. Whether it's our fears, our anxieties, our insecurities, intrusive thoughts, there's all of that going on. So the image of the disciples in the boat might give us a much clearer picture of what our prayer life looks like. And so the challenge then is that it's not about finding that place of absolute silence. It's not about finding that place where God's voice is going to ring out clearly for us to hear. The question and the challenge that this gospel passage calls us to ask is, how is it that we can listen for God's voice in the midst of everything else that is going on? In the midst of the noise of the storms, in the midst of our own thoughts, our own fears, how is it that we listen for God's voice cutting through all of that and calling to us, saying, "Take courage, it is I, be not afraid"? How do we, like Peter, say, "Lord, call me to come to you"? And then when Jesus calls us and says, "Come," how do we respond? There's a lesson in Peter's response as well. Because Peter, when he first hears that voice, gets out of the boat, and he is able to do great things. He is able to walk on water. But it's only when he begins to notice the noise and the storm and everything going on around him, and he focuses more on that than he does on Jesus in front of him, who is calling to him, that's when the fear takes over again. And that's when Peter is no longer able to walk on water, because he loses his focus on Christ, and he is no longer able to see Christ for the storm around us. That's the lesson for us, brothers and sisters. No matter what the storms we are facing, be they our own personal insecurities, be they the unrest that is present in the world, be they the uncertainties because of the pandemic that we are currently living through, we are called to keep our focus fixed on Christ and to allow him to lead us and to guide us through all of the storms and through all of the uncertainties in our lives. So as we continue this Eucharist this morning, perhaps we can make our prayer, Lord, increase my faith and remove my doubt so that I may follow you faithfully and I may not be distracted and discouraged and brought to fear by the storms of this life, but I may always seek to hear your voice calling out in the midst of all of the trials and storms of this life, calling me to come to you and to grow in holiness and faith and love. Amen. And so, as brothers and sisters united in the one faith, let us stand now and profess that faith which unites us. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day, he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From there, he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. With faith in the God who calls us to come to him, we ask for his intervention in the lives of all people.
With faith in God who calls us to come to him, we ask for his intervention in the lives of all people, for all God's people to listen for his call and to go to him, knowing he has come to save us. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For nations that are suffering from COVID-19, weather disasters, economic downfall, political unrest, and tragic loss, to be pulled out of their fear by the loving hand of Christ, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the outreach ministry of Assumption Cares, to offer a hand of hope and encouragement to those in need in our community as we seek safe ways to serve in this time of pandemic, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For families struggling to make ends meet while discerning the choices they must make for their children as the new school year approaches. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who are suffering physically, emotionally, and mentally from the challenges experienced worldwide in recent times, to find the place within where God speaks and there find peace. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who have died, especially Loretta D'Agnillo, Philip Melanson, Genevieve Zilli, and Ann Nada, to receive the Lord's embrace in everlasting life, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. And let us continue to keep in our prayers the people of Lebanon as they recover from the explosion that took place there earlier this week. We pray to the Lord. All-knowing and powerful God, help us to focus our hearts on you so that doubt and fear may not diminish our desire to be your missionary disciples on earth today. We ask this through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Be pleased, O Lord, to accept the offerings of your church, for in your mercy you have given them to be offered, and by your power you transform them into the mystery of our salvation. Through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For we know it belongs to your boundless glory that you came to the aid of mortal beings with your divinity, and even fashioned for us a remedy out of mortality itself, that the cause of our downfall might become the means of our salvation through Christ our Lord. Through him, the host of angels adores your majesty and rejoices in your presence forever. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in one chorus of exultant praise as we acclaim, Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Ronald Peter, our Bishop, Joseph, his auxiliary, and all the clergy and ministers of your church. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. At the Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer to each other a sign of peace. Lamb of God, behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Let us pray. May the communion in your sacrament that we have consumed save us, O Lord, and confirm us in the light of your truth. Through Christ our Lord. Just a couple of announcements. First off, a reminder that we have started posting, since we cannot have our children gather for Little Saints, we have started posting the videos for children for Little Saints on our website, along with the activity pages and things for them to do. If you watch the video and if you complete the activity, you can email a photo or a scanned copy of the completed activities to Jessica, our youth minister, and we will display those on our website. So be sure to check that out. Also, this coming Saturday, August 15th, is the Feast of the Assumption. It is our parish feast day. Because of the pandemic restrictions and everything like that, we can't have our parish picnic like we usually would. But in order to celebrate that feast day, instead of having an extra mass on the Saturday when fewer people can come, we're going to transfer the celebration of our parish feast to the Sunday masses for next weekend. So at all three of our Sunday masses, we will be celebrating the Feast of the Assumption, which is our parish feast day. And lastly, just a reminder for those of you who maybe are thinking of coming back to Mass, or this is you're slowly returning, just a reminder to please review all of the procedures and all of the guidelines on our website so that we can make sure that we're following those procedures and keep everyone safe. Thank you. I hope that you all have a blessed week. I'm going to go spend a few days with some of our bazillions in Toronto just for some rest and relaxation. So please keep me in your prayers this week as I will keep you in mine. The Lord be with you. And may Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.